Hey, this is Bridging Apps. So during the holidays, we know that you will have your loved ones, family, friends, close relatives around you, and you might want to share memories and old videos and pictures and just have some things that you can talk about and reminisce on old times. And one of the fun things that you can do with technology is you can actually take your phone and share content, videos, pictures, all kinds of things to your TV. You don't need a Apple TV. You don't need any other device, just a TV and your phone or an iPad. Just recently, I had my family over and we were all looking at the same little tiny screen. And I said to my stepfather, "Hey, do you know that we can share that on the TV?" He looked at me and said, "How?" And it was magical when we popped the video that he was showing me right up onto the TV. It was really cool. It was our TV, his phone, and he was amazed. All right, I'm going to demo how to mirror your phone or your iPad to your smart TV. Now, the TV I'm going to be using is an LG, and I have a remote that looks like this. So you're going to want, it is a smart TV, you're going to want to go to your dashboard. And in order to do that, you're going to press, I press this button. I'm going to get over to the little house, which on my home dashboard. And I see a screen that looks like that, working in the background. It tells me that I can jump over to mobile, which is over to the far left of my screen, and I can connect my mobile. I can also go to AirPlay, which is super, super cool because I don't even need a Apple TV to do it. So I'm gonna choose the center button, which I realize all remotes are different, but I'm gonna choose this one. It's with the two circles, almost like a little target. I've now got my phone or my iPad, whichever that I want to share. So I'm gonna, for the sake of this video, I'm gonna use my phone, and I am just going to go. Now there's a couple ways to do this. One of the easiest ways for me is to swipe down from the top, and I'm gonna go to this screen that allows me to do screen mirroring. It's almost a shortcut. And then I see some options. So I see living room, and then I said see another living room, but that is actually an Apple TV. I have an Apple TV in my house that I've since moved because I don't need it. It's actually in another bedroom. I could probably go and change the name. But I'm going to choose the one that looks like living room. There's also a Roku Express, which I can show you in another video. And I labeled it Sick Kid because we are in the time of quarantine and I've had to have a smart TV in different people's rooms. And so there is a way to make a TV a smart TV that I can show you later. So we've been able to rotate that from room to room if we've needed it. So I can go living room that looks like a TV. And this is the magic. My phone is now on my TV. So this lends itself to holidays and families being able to get together and talk about pictures of loved ones. Do you remember the time that we celebrated our birthdays at great grandma's house? And you could just literally swipe through on your phone and talk about loved ones. You can also go to streaming services like Netflix. And if I'm not sure why you'd need to, because you probably have Netflix if it's a smart TV, but you could if you wanted to stream Netflix from your phone. You could stream Netflix from your phone. You can choose a movie together. It's really a cool thing, especially if you don't need anything extra like an Apple TV. There is another thing I want to share with you, and unfortunately I don't have an Android device here with me, but I'm just gonna kind of talk you through it. So I'm using the same remote. I am going to go to the button that looks like the plug. And I am going to move my button over, or my red box over to home dashboard. I'm gonna click on those two circles so I can get to the home dashboard. Once I get there, again, you'll see that AirPlay pop up, but I am going to go over to where it says connect to mobile. Now this is using the Think for this particular TV, which is an LG. I can connect my mobile device to it using this little plus sign. So I'm gonna click on that. And then I could either use iOS or I could do Android. And then I am going to be given a QR code. The QR code directly takes me to the App Store where I can download the free app, which allows me to watch content on my device. So that's a really cool thing as well. So if you've got an Android device, again, I showed another way using the screen mirroring feature where I could just connect to my phone that way without using the LG ThinQ app. I have already downloaded it, or at least at one point, I've downloaded it on my phone, and it looks like that. There are other appliances that you might have in your home, like your washing machine. If it's a smart washing machine, I believe that's what I've used this app for, where I can kind of start a load if I want to during the middle of the day or before I get home so that the clothes aren't sitting there. It's amazing what you can do, but I'm using the same app for that. So this just works with your smart devices, and this allows you to stream content. I mentioned that we have another little device. It's called the Roku Express. I've labeled it Sick Kid because it rotates from room to room if we need to quarantine somebody. And the cool thing about it is it's simply like this little tiny device. And what's great is it will turn a regular TV that has HDMI ports into a smart TV. And at the same time, the bonus is you can mirror your device to it as well. So you can have the great content for streaming services with just purchasing this little Roku Express box. Another option that works similarly, and it's also inexpensive in turning your TV into a smart TV, is the Google Chromecast. Okay, I'm actually in my craft room right now. This is not a smart TV. This is an old Sanyo. It does have HDMI connections. It's not connected to cable. I'm using a little device, which is also very old, or pretty old. It's a Chromecast. And I'll pull it out after we're done with this video and show it to you. It powers the device and also connects to the TV at the same time. So I don't want to unplug it quite yet. You see these beautiful landscape pictures. This is connected to Google. I've already set it up, and I'm using the Google Home app to set it up, which I can show you once we're done. But again, this is another cool feature, and you can use it with your Android device and also your iOS devices. So what I love about this one, and this is, again, my little crafting room, so my kids will watch YouTube videos. They will connect my computer to it, actually. But I can go to my Xfinity, which is my streaming service. And I'm going to open that up. And I'm going to use Chromecast this time. So the button for Chromecast, the icon looks a little bit different. But I will just... It uses the Google Home app, so it's the second one with the home icon. I'm not gonna use it quite yet, but that's what I would set it up with. And what I really love about this is I could be in my little project room and I can put on Xfinity which I don't have a cable box in here. I just have, trying to type with one hand. I just have I just have Wi-Fi. So I can go to my Xfinity app, which is that second stream app, and I can literally stream. So I was watching halftime, like a halftime report, or if I want to put the news on, I am going to go to this. Apologize, I'm trying to do this one handle. I'm going to go to that button right there.
Thumbtack to find exterminators, electricians, roofers, and plumbers.
Do you want to cast a project room? I sure do.
I can check out
reviews. It will tell me Xfinity stream is loading.
So anytime something breaks,
and on my phone, it will say casting to project room TV. It does take a second for it to come right up. But this is a great feature for being able to share streaming on TVs that are not smart TVs. Again, when I purchased this, it was only about $35. They've upgraded them since. I can change the channels. So I just tapped on a different channel and now I've got the news. We hope this has been helpful to you as you're in a season in life that you can sit down with your family, with your friends and loved ones. You can look at your own devices and share those videos and photos and make each other smile. Enjoy your time together.